Tice Suplee, and I'm a director of bird conservation and currently interim executive director with Audubon Arizona. Horses have been along this river corridor for many decades at some level or another. This population has no status under the Federal Wild Horse and Burro Act. It's considered a feral population, not wild under the definition of that law. This desert and its plant ecology did not evolve with a major plant-eating animal like a horse. These horses are accepted where free-ranging wild cattle would not be accepted. Free-ranging wild dogs would not be accepted. So an agency like our Forest Service is really faced with a management challenge. The National Audubon Society chapters are on record as expressing concern about the vegetative damage that these animals can cause. Horses eat vegetation. They primarily like grass. You'll look around here, you don't see much. There's no grass, there's no shrubs. When they can't find their preferred food, they start going for secondary food. And they'll strip the bark from trees. The tree that's most impacted by horses and also burros is our native Palo Verde, where they'll strip the bark, they'll break off the branches. These horses will eat every single seedling of cottonwood and willow that comes up. So even if we wanted to establish new young trees, as this horse herd increases, it would be very difficult to achieve that objective. The horses are unmanaged. They're here 24/7. And so the frustration for the Audubon Society is we've been very successful working with ranchers and implementing best management practices for cattle grazing. These feral horses, nobody owns them, nobody's managing them. The idea that, well, you can always have a few around here, as long as they hang in these corridors, which they do, they're gonna have an unequal impact in this ecological system. You know, the Audubon position at the moment is not eradication, not full removal. We're advocating for management.